Welcome to Walk the Talk. I'm Shekhar Gupta, in my neighborhood, in fact. And my guest today, my most famous and redoubtable neighbor, Fali Nariman, the youngest, bravest voice in Indian law and judiciary.
No, the oldest.
The body may be the oldest, but the voice is the youngest and the bravest. And carries the most weight. What you're trying to say, Fali, in your latest book now, God Save the Honorable Supreme Court.
See, I felt very distressed when all these things happened, particularly after that interview to the press and everybody saying all sorts of things, one way or another, lawyers taking sides. In my 67 years of practice in the High Court and the Supreme Court, I've never come across something so demeaning as this. Right. I felt very, very sad, very sad.
You think the judges should not have held that press conference?
Of course not. For the simple reason, not because of anything else, they should have had it out within the four walls. There are certain things that can't be done and they should not be done.
But their view was that it wasn't working. They had tried their best, but it wasn't working. It
makes no difference. If it wasn't working and if you don't like it, then you lump it. You either wait till the judge, till the Chief Justice retires, or you go away.
You resign and go away.
Whatever, whichever.
Right.
See, I give you an instance, and that is stated in the book also. Justice Kapadia,
right,
when he became Chief Justice, he was Chief Justice for 2 years. The day he took over as Chief Justice, he stopped any mentioning in any court by any counsel, including his own court. Now, it's a very important thing for counsel to mention something. Right. Something's going wrong, I want to mention, have the matter put. He said, no, it can't be done, go to the office, do it. Everybody complained, but judges complained, lawyers complained, but then it was went on. For 2 years it lasted. The moment his successor came in, he restored the position. And after that, everybody was mentioning in all.
So these four erred in going public.
Of course they did.
They did it out of frustration, that you could see.
But that's their way of that. We are not concerned with their frustration.
Right.
We are concerned with the Supreme Court. We are concerned with the institution. If you read just now Chief Justice Roberts' judgment supporting Trump's immigration measure,
if you remember, just now,
it came a few days ago. He meets the question of why does this president make all sorts of, what are those called, tweets all over every single day and demeans himself. And his answer is that we don't deal with individual presidents in this court. We deal with the office of the president.
Right.
You see, that's the important thing. So you have to deal with the office of a judge whilst you are in the Supreme Court. You are somebody. Doesn't matter. When you are appointed judge of the Supreme Court, whether you deserve it or don't deserve it, you are somebody. You therefore have to have a certain ethos, a certain set of principles which are different from everybody else.
So who brought more disrepute to the court? These four judges?
I don't care. That's a wrong question. I won't answer that.
So who?
Nobody brought disrepute. I don't want the court to be disreputed. Right. I don't see. You see, the important thing is we must preserve the dignity and honor of the court, not for any other reason, not for the judges. Because we've had 240 judges in the past.
Right.
Who bothers about them? Who remembers them? Hardly any.
Barring four or five.
Yeah, barring the top people and you can count
some
them on your
some for good reasons, a couple for not very good reasons.
Doesn't matter, whatever it is. You see, we are not concerned with all these origins. After 100 years, you can write a history of the Supreme Court and say whatever you like. But whilst it's functioning, it is the sole and final interpreter of the Constitution. Please remember that. Everybody's life and liberty depends upon the highest court. Therefore, whether they realize it or don't realize it, they must realize it, all the judges together.
So, in fact, Justice Sikri, responding to Shanti Bhushan in his case, said that the biggest damage to the courts is done if people people start doubting the courts.
You see, I don't understand this. Why your senior counsel are not pulled up?
Right.
When they say that, please tell me, how did you come to be constituted in this bench? Ridiculous. Ridiculous.
It's not their business.
It's not only not their business, but that is the business of the Chief Justice.
Right.
Of every court.
Right.
So there's no question of asking you, how are you constituted? If a man today sits in court number 6, I can't go up to him and ask him. I might as well then ask him for his warrant of appointment. Should he carry it in his pocket? It's a ridiculous thing.
So this question,
this question is
wrong.
This question, the whole thing is wrong. I'm very sorry.
So is the Chief Justice right in the way he has run the roster?
I don't know about the roster. And I'm not interested. The roster, he is the master.
Chief Justice is the master.
The Chief Justice, yes, he is the master, but he must reach out also. Every judge in the court must reach out. That is why I spoke about collegiality.
Right.
Yeah, there has to be a collegiality. You can't otherwise sit in a whole team. You have to function as a team. You'll find from the rules, one judge means nothing.
Nothing, yes.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah, even under the Arbitration Act, although one judge appoints an arbitrator, but his decision, even if he says something, is not binding.
Right.
You'll find that.
You need a team of judges.
You need a team, two.
At least two. Could the Chief Justice have handled this better by talking to his colleagues?
Of course he could.
Open?
Of course he could. And vice versa.
And vice versa.
Yeah, that's important. Who knows what happened? We don't know. I don't know. You don't know. We all assume that this happened, that happened, this happened,
well,
that happened.
One thing that we know that happened is that none of the constitution benches had one of these 4 senior most judges.
No, I'm very sorry. I have written if you read my the first chapter, the very first chapter will tell you how many judges sat in which matters where very important judgments were delivered from the year January 2017 under 2 other chief justices as well as this chief justice right up to date. You see, it's a matter entirely for the court.
Right.
Who sits where, what, etc., etc. It's never that the first 5 or first 7.
So all judges should be treated the same.
Yes, of course. The 5 are important only for one reason, because of the judgment of Justice Verma in the second judge's case, where he said that he said 3, of course, and then it became 5. There should be more people than the Chief Justice. And that was in the context of Justice Ray not appointing proper judges, kowtowing to the government.
In Indira Gandhi's times.
Yeah, Indira Gandhi's time, transferring judges despite the fact they shouldn't be transferred. And do you know why the transfer policy was stopped by Mr. Justice Ray, Chief Justice Ray?
Why?
Only because one of the transferred judges who said, I shouldn't be transferred because my health is not good, from Bombay, he died in Calcutta.
Oh, I see.
So they said this is a very bad backlash against the political party.
So we can't have
happen. So it was not a judge, but a politician who stopped it.
So now one of the 4 judges is gone, Justice Chelmeshwar. 3 are left. Other 2 will also go in the course of time, in not a very long time. How does the Chief Justice now bring order back in the court?
He should bring, how he brings it is his job. He must bring it, that's all I'm saying. That's his job. That's how he has to, because he's the leader. I didn't appoint him leader, you didn't appoint him leader. He became a leader because of the convention, constitutional convention, that the senior-most judge should become Chief Justice. And that senior-most, that convention, you must remember, came only because Chief Justice Kanya, the first Chief Justice, died within a few months of his assuming office. He fell ill and died. And it was suggested that they should bring Justice M.C. Chagla, Chief Justice of Bombay, as Chief Justice of India. And the 4 or 5 judges who were remaining in the Supreme Court, in those days it was the Supreme Court was of 7, said, no, not at all, we can't have that. In which event, Justice Patanjali Shastri, the next successor, was appointed. That's right. How the convention came.
Right. That's how the senior most gets it.
Yeah.
So, but still, you are the dean of the judiciary.
No, I'm not dean. I am just a person who has practiced for 67 years.
That makes the dean.
Far too long.
That makes the dean of the judiciary.
Far too long.
So, if, I mean, you have to have some prescription now that how to bring calm back. Because it's bad for everybody that there is a sense
there
of.
There must be a reaching out by the Chief Justice, this Chief Justice, the successor Chief Justice, who has to be Justice Gogoi. They can't have a super session again. We've had two super sessions.
And each was disastrous.
And each was disastrous, and it's bad for the institution.
Right.
Yeah.
But do you have any apprehension there might be a.
No, I have no apprehension. At least I don't think there can be any such thing.
Because Mr. Amit Shah said that, appointment will be decided by who the outgoing Chief Justice recommends.
No, that's a recommendation. That's not a convention.
I see.
The convention is, please don't, you must remember there are two things. The recommendation of the Chief Justice is not a convention.
I see.
He can recommend number 7.
I see.
But he needn't be appointed. What the convention only is that the senior most judge should be Chief Justice. And Justice Kuldeep Singh in the second judge's case has said that this constitutional convention is law. It's very important.
So they cannot get over it.
Without an amendment to the constitution, you can't.
This is a benighted city.
Of course.
You know, there's gossip and there is, you know, this and there is this. And now the predominant gossip is about this. Sort of the sexiest gossip is about who will be the next Chief Justice,
yes.
Because this government will not allow Justice Gogoi because he attended the press conference.
Not at all. Justice Gogoi has to be appointed being the senior most judge.
Right.
There's no doubt about in my mind. There's no doubt in the mind of any right thinking person.
Right. And if
I can't speak for the wrong thinkers.
Right. And if it is done, it will be a wrong step.
It will be a totally wrong step. It will also be unconstitutional. You must remember, a constitutional convention is as good as a constitutional provision.